Yo, what's up, my crazy subscriber? This is Joking Johnson 4 here, bringing you guys some tips for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Today, we're going to be customizing the class for the SN6. This best class setup is mostly set up for short situations, guys, like 1v1, hallway situations, you know, people are like running in front of your face situations. Those kind of moments is when you use the SN6, guys, when you have small maps in the presence and also a lot of tight corridors. So keep it on those situations, guys. Do not go out there on large maps expect to get a kill, because this gun is gonna rattle on you like very bad, and it's no good for long situations, long range situations, and medium range. So keep it on the tight corridors maps, and also if you're playing the big map and you accidentally click on this class setup, make sure you stick around the small corridors, guys. So let's move on to the best class setup. The SN6 is located in the SMG division. It's the third gun to unlock. I believe it's pretty much easy to unlock. You have to play like maybe like 30 minutes and it'll be unlocked right away. One of the great things about the SN6 is that the damage is pretty much okay. It doesn't tell you actually on stats. It doesn't tell you that it's super strong. But when you play the game, when you're during the gameplay, guys, gameplay wise, the gun wastes at least one third of the mag on an enemy. You can take out three enemies with one mag. That's how strong this gun is. Maybe like around 62% of the time you take out an enemy like half of the mag, but it's like the other percentage after 62% is one third. So it is an ammo saver, guys, because it does make some good amount of damage. Moving on to the attachments, attachments are rapid fire, quick draw grip, and red dot sight. Now, there's a difference between the gameplay that I played yesterday and the best class setup that I have now. Yesterday, I had the foregrip, the one that stabilizes your accuracy. Now, that one I took it off because I noticed this gun becomes useless from long range to medium range. So I was like, you know what, why do I need all this accuracy if I can't even shoot from medium range to long range? So I took it off at the quick draw grip, and now I'm actually stronger from close range. So keep it on the tight corridors, guys, because now you have quick draw grip, which means you can always beat your opponent when it comes down face to face, guys. That's why you need the quick draw grip. And once you get that done, guys, you're pretty much going to surprise the enemies. Moving on to the next attachment, the red dot sight is going to give you more of a clear view. Even though the default class, the SN6, does have a red dot sight, the problem is it will throw you off. It has like a little arrow on the red dot sight, but it's pretty minuscular. It's a small red dot sight. That's the smallest red dot sight I've ever seen in my life. And it throws you off. It actually covers your aim. It's pretty weird. So I don't know. I never trusted that red dot sight. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to get a regular one so I can get more of a clear shot. So I added the regular one, and I'm actually more accurate since then. Without it, I was like, this gun seemed kind of weird. The iron sight is just dumb. It's stupid. I never liked the freaking regular red dot sight that it has. So yeah, that's why I picked up this gun with the red dot sight in the attachments category. Moving on to the next attachment will be the rapid fire. This is very important, guys. If you guys want to actually beat everyone that comes to your face, guys, that's like right up to your face, at the rapid fire, all that damage that you have on your gun will go directly to his body as quick as possible before he kills you. You will end up bleeding, and that's it. Most of the time when he shoots first and you take him off first, you're gonna end up bleeding, guys. You're gonna have damage walking around because you took him off first. You're not gonna die, I promise you that. When he pops into your face, he shots you first, you can actually take him off first because you had the rapid fire, and the amount of damage this gun does, you're gonna take him off first, guys. So it's very important. You gotta make the damage first. So that's why you gotta add the rapid fire. It becomes more stronger from short range along with the quick draw grip. These two combos right here is gonna make you deadly when it comes down to 1v1 situations. And with the red dot sight, you have more of a clear shot. So that's the only thing that's increasing your accuracy when it comes down to aiming for the SN6. Moving on to the perks, I have low profile, blast suppressor, and hardwired. Hardwired, guys, seriously, you really need it on this freaking game, since system hack is being spammed like 90% of the goddamn time when you go online. So have enough space for hardwired. The other two perks, you can have whatever you want, since it doesn't really affect the gun. But I personally used low profile and blast suppressor because I want to be stealthy. I want to advance behind the enemy lines and kill them all. That's why I have those two perks. Don't come up with the excuse of, you know, oh, you have low pro, blah, blah. Okay, then go get killed then. Because, you know, spy plane is also being spammed 80% of the time. Okay, good luck without playing without profile. Unless you're good, then you don't really need it. So, anyways, Moving on to the next equipment that we have here, EXO Overclock. The EXO Overclock is pretty much going to allow you to take off real quick. You can have whatever you want, but I personally use EXO Overclock. And also on the EXO Launcher, I have the Stun Grenade. You can use whatever you want, but I like to use a Stun Grenade because once my opponents are frozen, they can't really move, and I'm going to take them out. And I know where it pretty much at. It's pretty much like a, it know, lets you know who's around. And once they actually get a hit marker on them with the stun grenade, they slow down, so they don't have enough speed to actually aim towards you. It's pretty good if you ask me. I've used the stun grenade a few times, and I got him some good kills. If you guys might want to go back into my two gameplays that I showed you guys yesterday and the day before, I did use the stun grenade to kill some enemies. On the kill streaks, I have the UAV and the remote turret for now. It's just that I usually play around with the kill streaks. I'm still not comfortable with the score streaks because they're all weak. So you can have whatever you like, guys. You can have whatever you like on the score streak. I don't mind. You can use the little shooting one from the sky or whatever, you know. You can have whatever you want. System hack, whatever you guys want. And you're going to need the wild card 1 and wild card 2 in order for you to have some of the attachments and some of the perks that you see on your screen. So that's it for now, guys. If you guys like this class setup, make sure you leave a like. If you guys got any comments about this class setup, make sure you leave a comment in the comment section. So, and also, you got some questions, leave it in the comment section. I'll answer it for you. So that's it, guys. Leave a like, leave a comment, tell me what's up, and subscribe for more, guys. If you guys want to see more Call of Duty Advanced Warfare.